In this video, I will cover UI images that follow 3D game objects. As you can see, the exclamation point is above the dummy character's head. These images always follow the dummy character's head, and they are rendered in the screen overlay environment of Canvas. Let's see how to make it. Let's start with the principle. Currently, all game objects are in 3D space. These game objects are rendered on the screen through the main camera. In order to implement a UI image that tracks a 3D position, 3D coordinates must be changed to fit 2D. Unity provides a function called WorldToScreenPoint to solve this problem. Let me explain the dummy NPC character. This virtual character has a head and a body. We are going to have a UI image above the character's head. First, let's create a UI image that will be displayed on the screen. Drag and drop it to the prefab folder to make it a prefab object. I'm going to remove the image from the scene. Now we will create a script file and name it Manager NPC UI. Since we will be using a UI image, we will use the Unity UI directive. Let's create an image prefab variable that will be used in the scene. Next, let's create an image variable that will be used directly in the scene. In the start method, I will use the instantiate command to use the image prefab. Since the image must be driven inside the canvas, set the parent of the image to the same as the screen. Because I used an image variable, I must get image component to avoid the problem. Next, we need to move the image according to the position of the game object. As explained earlier, the coordinates of the 3D game object must be changed to fit the 2D. Since the main camera is in charge of drawing the screen, I will switch the coordinates to match the ratio of the main camera. The code that changes the location of the UI image according to the position with the NPC has been completed. Let's check it out. Drag and drop the script to the NPC and apply the image to the prefab UI variable. You can see the UI image is updated in position along the dummy character. We want the image to be displayed above the character's head, so let's make some modifications. I will create a transform variable, and apply the character's head to the variable. Then, let's change the object whose location should be referenced with the variable I just created. It is confirmed that the position of the image is higher than before, but it is still not the position we want. Let's modify the position by adding the vector 3 variable. Repositioning of the image only allows x and y values. Let's set the y value to 1.5. Simply add it after the reference variable and it's done. It is confirmed that the position of the image is correct. In the next video, we will look at the function of changing the image size depending on the distance between the player and the dummy character. Thank you. See you next time.